Okay, I'm doing contest now. This was the first one and one of the most probably horrific ones for me. It was a good contest and I participated gloriously and got to the let me see. The glorious 2257th place. Yeah. The point of these shitty videos would be first of all to give some sort of an educational content of what the solutions were and how I solved them in the stressful contest time, and also to kind of track the progress. Anyway, so this will be the very quick overview of the first four solutions, and obviously the first three are not something too important. Well, I'll just go through with it for the sake of the protocol itself. So the first one was just two intervals, and we want to calculate the intersection of them at how many spots they intersect, 0, 3, 1, 5, 2 spots. Nothing really crazy, nothing interesting. Except the interesting is the puzzling solution, which is like this. With a vector, marking, and then calculating how many places we mark twice. As opposed to writing ifs. And why we can do that? Because it's up to 100. Yeah. Okay. So this was it. Nothing interesting here. This one, so it's like very quickly, it's like a a two-dimensional grid with all the players having played against each other, and ij represents the result of it, and the question is whether it's valid or not. And if only it's valid in a case where when the ing are equal, it should be a minus, which means there was no game, nobody plays the game with himself. And if they are not equal, then the wins and losses should be symmetric. And if they are not, then there is something wrong with that. And the draws also should be symmetric. So symmetrically, the top triangle of the matrix should be equal to the bottom triangle. Equal means W should be L and D should be D. And this is like a very simple, again, like a very simple validation of the matrices. Equal. Then check if it's a dash. And then, if they are equal and both of them are D, is fine. If they are not equal and they are opposing, one is W and one is L, or the other way, it's fine. Otherwise, it's not fine, and then print the answer. So this is pretty much it. Nothing too exciting here as well. So the third one, probably the least exciting one, it's like there are like this file creations, like in operating systems, create a file, and if they are the same names which we have seen previously, we want to append the number, which is how many times we've already seen that, to keep the uniqueness of it. Okay, for this one, again, nothing very special, using an unordered map of how many times we saw it. Unordered map is the hash table for the non-C++ users, so very quick access for the strings, even though we have 10 to the power of 5, let's keep how many we have. If we don't have, it is the answer. If we have, then it is the answer plus these braces and how many there are. Okay, so this is also pretty much it. I think one thing that is worth talking about is this one, which is more or less a decent one. So the statement is tricky, and the input is also tricky. But the statement is this. So there are coin tosses consecutively. There are two ways a coin can end up, 1 and 0. If it ends up, let's say, a heads, which you can call as the 1, then we calculate how many times there were consecutive heads. The counter's value increased by 1. If it falls to tails, then the counter gets to 0. So again, the question is consecutive heads. So for each head, there is a specific reward, depending on at which location it is. It's a whole array of x's. So all of this, if the first one falls head, you get 2, if the second one falls head, 7, third one, 1, fourth one, 8, and so on. And there are also these trick bonuses, that if you get consecutive number of heads, C1, you get this many points. Consecutive number C2, this many points. So all of these are unique, and the question obviously is to choose the outcomes to make the total points as high as possible. Okay, so like this example is a very good example of how this strict bonuses are being used, because you get two. If you get two consecutively, you get 10. So since 10 is pretty big here and the others are 1 and 5, then it's kind of a good idea to get a 2 and then reset it to 0 and then come back to the 2, well, depending on these things, of course. So anyway, this is, I will use the sketchpad to very quickly give out the outline of this. So we also have the most important thing in this, which make this task solvable, 5000. So this is a very good variation of the dynamic programming, and the question is this. So let's say that f gives an answer to the following question. So it has two parameters. Let's say it can even have one, but let's consider one. So let's say that this kind of an f for two parameters, let's mark them n and let's mark them, let's say s for strings. So n is the count, s is the strings. Okay, so what this says is for coins 1 to n included, let's make that this way, for the streak being the last streak as of the coin n, so the last streak, which is consecutive number of ones, is s, then the v value which this shows is kind of the answer for both of this, which means, so f 2 1 would mean that we toss two coins. After the last toss, the one was the consecutive number of heads, and it equals some kind of v0. Anyway, the point of this is to consider all of the cases in the following manner. So let's say that, for example, up to some kind of an n, we know all the answers for, let me write this on the top, there can be at most n tosses. So we know the answer of, I will write this a182, an. So this table will show that we assume that we know the answers. The answers for up to n, for the first n coins that we tossed, and the last streak that it ended with 0, which means it ended with tails, the answer is A1, the answer being the best of the best. So for n coins where we chose that the last one is 1, the answer is A2. For the n coin tosses where we chose the last two being heads, the answer is A3, and so on and so on. Okay, so when we have a new coin toss, right, I will name the this C and Y are pretty tricky, but there are too many layers, so you have to keep all of them in mind. So okay, so let's say that we have one more coin, n plus one coin. Can we use this to kind of access all the previous answers and create new answers? Let's say, and we can. And by how we can do this? By just simply doing all the possible variations. And all the possible variations of this is like this. So we chose two outcomes, of course, heads or tails, for the n plus one coin. So if we are going for tails, then what this means is that our streak is going to be 0. So our f n plus one 0 is going to be equal the maximum of whatever we had from the previous row, let's say fn and all of them, and our streak is going to be 0. So we can choose to kind of nullify it, so we have the new coin, we chose to make it tails, so for fn plus 1 0 it will be the maximum from the previous row, and this will nullify it. Otherwise, if this goes heads, then for each, let's say I streak that we had previously, we currently are choosing to have a new streak, which means we are having fn plus 1 I plus 1 equal to what we had before, which is I, this is, plus the streak, let's say a streak for I plus 1 coins, plus n plus 1, this is the x, n plus 1, the reward for the current heads. And we kind of have to choose the maximum of all of this. If none of this made any sense, the code might make some senses. So, with that logic, I kept the two-dimensional vector, but you can go with just the one-dimensional. Anyway, so those are the streaks. I just mapped them, which one is which. This is the initial array. Alright. So, initially, the first row shows the number of coins. The second row shows the streak itself. So I'll put -1 initially, uninitialized. For 0, 0, it's 0, right? There are no coins, there are no streaks, and it's 0. Okay, so for each coin, if we go like this, try the tails, then we just need to check the maximum and assign it to the first one, which means after our new coin, if we choose to have the streak get back to 0, we'll just have the maximum of the previous answer. Otherwise, if we chose it to be heads, then this is just a checking case, then this is how it's going to be calculated. So take the value of the current heads, which is I minus 1 because I started with 1, add the previous streak. So j is the streak here. I'm going over all of the streaks. So j is the streak plus our current value, this one, and plus the streak bonus. And then update the answer accordingly, whether it's better or not, and then output. I hope this made sense, because I'm going to make this type of shitty videos a lot more. Anyway, we are done for today.